Hello, I'm Jacob Kesslar. This is Seth and this is Brad, and they are expert Glasgow Scotty soccer ball players. Today, they're going to try to give me a private lesson on how to play soccer. This is going to go good.
It's a private lesson.
So what got you into soccer? What made you say that soccer is for you?
I guess I wanted to play a sport where I could run a bunch, and soccer allowed me to do that. So do you
run a lot in soccer?
Of course.
You never stuck on the bench?
I used to, yeah. You just got to practice. And
so you became a good enough player?
Yeah.
How good would you say you are?
I wouldn't say I'm that good.
Good enough.
Other people in other states are really good, so.
So you're good enough.
I guess, yeah.
What was your most memorable moment in soccer out of all your years of playing?
I guess in the game against Greenwood when I was first playing goalkeeper, and I got more than like 15 saves or something in one game, and I feel like that was pretty cool. So.
Sounds pretty important. So you're so used to playing a goalie, so how does it feel playing other positions?
Well, fortunately, I've been trained in both, so I'm used to playing both. I can play wherever the coach needs me to play.
Okay.
But it's sometimes weird if someone kicks the ball and I'm playing defense or something. I might throw my hands up, but I can be able to stop myself.
Good. So I'm here for a private lesson from you and Brad. So what is something that you think you are able to teach a fat guy like me?
I guess I can try to teach you some juggling.
All right, that sounds good to me.
All right, Jacob. So first, I'm going to be teaching you how to juggle.
Mm-hmm.
Not like, you know, the juggle you clowns do, but like with the feet.
I'll do that back in the day.
All right, so the first thing you want to do is, like, you drop it and then hit it off your foot and try to make it go back, like, near you.
Okay.
So, like, yeah.
Yeah, I'll give that a go.
See how it comes right back to you?
I did see that.
And all
that
you
did
gotta
not
do,
come back to me.
Yeah, all you gotta do is just try to keep it near you.
How long would you say it's taken you to basically learn all the tricks you know today?
Probably a long time from when I first started to now.
Probably when
really.
You first started, oh.
It's easy to like see people do it, but to actually copy exactly how they're doing it.
Yeah, like I'm trying to do right now. Yeah,
it's not
really too easy.
Because when I first juggled, I couldn't even do what you're doing.
Yeah.
Like, it was so bad. You get as many touches before it hits the ground.
How many touches do you want me to go for?
Let's do five.
Five touches, let's see.
One. Yes, yes, see? See?
I only got two.
Hey, two is better than when you first started.
Oh! Just. Apparently, I'm doing good.
You got three.
Oh! I got four.
I don't know. Like that. I bounce with it because it's easier for me.
Okay. I'll give that a go then. Oh! Oh! Oh!
I got to 4, but I didn't get to my goal 5. So maybe next time, when I'm practicing again, or on my own, I'll be able to do that. Ah!
Thanks for watching the Scotty Channel.
Did you know you can watch these videos for free?
Yeah, at thescottychannel.com.
Thanks for watching the Scotty Channel.
So what got you into soccer? What made you say that you wanted to start playing soccer?
I would think as a kid, I've tried every sport. I just wanted to try everything and just fell in love with soccer, really.
And you felt like soccer was the sport for you?
Yeah, personally, yeah.
What do you think, out of all of your years of playing soccer, was the most memorable moment you've had in soccer where you just, it's your most memorable moment, your favorite moment?
Probably my first ever goal ever. Like, as a kid, like, it's one of the things that I only remember from childhood. Is just one of your, scoring your first goal. It's what made you fall in love with it.
How old were you when you got your first goal?
5 or 6. Probably.
And how many years have you been playing soccer?
Ever since then.
So 5 or 6, that's about, what, 12 to 11 years?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Playing soccer for that long.
Yeah.
You think you could teach me all of your experience within, how much do we have? 15 minutes?
Oh, for sure.
Sounds good to me.
All right. The first thing I'm going to teach you is shooting.
Shooting.
So, first off, I want to see what your form looks like now. So, go ahead, do it.
Does this look good? Heroic? Awesome?
That's great. I'm proud.
I can see myself being a future soccer player right now.
I can see it. I see it now.
Even though that's not what my career focuses on. Alright. Just take a shot. You think I'm good?
Yeah, I just want to see where you're at. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to get your run-up done. So whenever you're with the ball, you have the ball. When you want to take a shot, you're in your brain, you take a longer touch than usual. You jump. So you jump. And you want your, what's your dominant foot?
My right one.
Okay. So you want your left foot. When you jump, almost just like this,
mm-hmm.
You want to be over the ball with your chest, over the ball. Like, naturally, your body wants to lean back.
Yeah.
But you want to lean over the ball and then keep your foot down like this and just come through. It feels awkward at first. Trust me, I know exactly what it feels like. It feels very awkward doing it in the motion, but once you just do it, it feels a lot better. But you have to keep mentally, you have to keep doing it.
Okay. All right, so it's a long kick. That does not, okay, yeah. It made it, but it's not what I was intended for. Yeah. I think I'm pointing my leg up too high. I don't know if I'm doing better at shooting than I was juggling. Oh, come on! Oh! Oh! Oh, come on! Oh! Oh!
Use his hands! Hey!
Now come on! Yeah.
Just wing it.
Oh! No. It's not the next one. That's not good.
You know you can watch the Scotty Channel.
Scotty Channel on YouTube.
Thanks for watching the Scotty Channel.
Jacob, I tried to teach you juggling. It did pretty good. I think so. You got the 4. That's better than 0.
Right? Absolutely.
Now I'm going to try to teach you how to play goalkeeper.
Oh, that's what I did.
All you got to do is know the motions, all right? And you cannot be afraid if you see a 6'7" dude running at you full speed, very muscular, shooting at you.
What?
Well, I'm going to teach you how to catch the ball, let's say, if they kick it from outside the 18-yard box.
How tall did you say?
All right, so whenever you're catching a ball, if they're shooting from pretty far out there and you want to, like, hold onto the ball, you have to catch it like a basket, okay?
Okay.
Like, you have to, like, let it hit your stomach and bring it in.
All right.
Because most people, when they do it, they try to catch it like that.
Ew.
And instead, it's just going to bounce and fall. So if you can bring it in, especially on hard shots, if you can catch it, it might take your breath away, but you'll be perfectly fine. Boom. And if it's ever short, you have to run towards it. All right? There you go. Good. So, like, if someone's running at you, right? Like, super tall, and you want to get there before they get there, you can always jump. You put one knee up, tie in the air, one knee, catch it like a diamond, something like that, if it's that high up.
Yeah. What do you do about long shots? Like, someone has just kicked the ball to the goal and it's coming at you like 50 miles an hour. What do you do about that?
Okay, so the first thing you want to do is follow the ball if you're in the goal. Okay. So let's say you're in the goal, right?
Yeah.
I'm out here.
Yeah.
If the ball's over here, you shift to where the ball's kind of like in between your legs.
Yeah.
And then make sure that you're like not too far outside your post.
Okay.
And then if someone like, you know, shoots it at you,
they make a point.
That's where the goalkeeper comes in. There you go. Right. So you see me? I'm dribbling over here. See? Good. When you shift, make sure it's like a constant motion.
Yeah.
And then if someone shoots...
I mean...
That's the thing about goalkeepers. You can use your hands. It's put like your foot right here, and then your knee. Okay. So that way it doesn't go through your legs. And then once it rolls, you pick it up. Good. Except there, my legs are a little bit
too far. Yeah.
Good.
Do I look like a future soccer player?
I mean.
No. Anyway. I don't. Oh. I guess that works.
This is. I do it to your side. Oh, that's my fault. And then here, one more time. Yeah. Okay. Except I'm gonna be kicking. Right. So remember what I said? Follow the ball.
Yeah.
The dribbling. And then ground shot.
Clear the goal! Clear the goal! Open goal!
Medic!
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue.
Boom.
For me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
So, how'd it go today?
Honestly, better than expected. I mean, I got hit once, but I've probably been hit more than I've ever been hit. So, I felt pretty confident in myself. I felt pretty good. Well, Seth and Brad have given me a private lesson on how to play soccer. I'd say they did a pretty good job. How did I do?
Pretty good.
Oh. Oh well. Thanks for watching the Scotty Channel.
get you where we are.
Nice.